Okay, I want to do a little video here on this TOZ-16. This appears to be a fairly old one. Doesn't have the grooves for a scope. I started making these, I guess, around 56 or something like that, as far as I can find on the internet. But it does have a 63 stamp under the butt plate, but I don't know if that's the year or just some other random marking, because it has all kinds of little proof marks everywhere. But so we'll just go over some of the things about it, and probably have a shooting video of it sometime. But it's got this, it's like a, must be birch, I guess most Russian guns are, and it's got this like stain, and then sort of like a slack on it to it, but it's almost looks like they kind of like burned it, but I don't know if it's, I guess it's just the stain. But you got checkering here, normal just metal butt plate. Everything is, you know, metal or wood on this. Those miniature sling swivels, metal trigger guard, trigger. It's got a nice sort of a two-stage kind of trigger onto it, which is kind of nice. Really, well, it's just a single shot, but the bolt is, I don't know, fairly complicated for what it is. I don't know, we'll take that and look at it in a minute, but it's just a single shot, and it has a feeding sort of thing here. You can see it. You just drop the cartridge onto it. Put the cartridge on it like that, and then it'll just feed it in. So it's kind of nice. And it's got some safeties on it. You can put it in safe there, but you can also, when it's cocked, you can put it like that. You can still open it when that's like that, so I guess you can load it with the safety on, I suppose. I think the big attraction, sort of why I like this thing, is the back sight here. It goes from 25 all the way up to 250 meters. A little, I don't know, kind of like a little mini Mosin back sight or AK sight or something, or SKS. It's put into a groove and pinned on, and then the barrel is just a straight taper, and then there's this weird thing. All the early guns are like this. It's like anti-glare grooves, and then it sight sits up on this big bell thing, and then it's counterbored quite a bit. It goes back, I forget how far, it's back an inch or so anyway. So most of the early guns are like this. I don't know really the reason for it, but it's kind of neat anyway. And this one just has the Tula. It's like a triangle with a sort of a circle thing around it, and it says made in USSR. That's all this one says. It doesn't say the model or anything on it. But there's that checkering, which, I don't know, it's a little bit of grip, I guess. That sling swivel up front. But overall, it's pretty nice. They're pretty robust. They're pretty accurate. I guess they're sighted in for like standard velocity. I don't know if the Russians ever loaded high velocity. I don't really. So I got this stuff here, which is that fine quality Russian steel case 22 stuff. So, still got a few left. I shot off a few in the old days, but there's a steel case, and I got a very greasy 40 grain bullet. So I hear they don't work after a while, but they get kind of poor with age. But they did work when I bought them originally. But let's see, these cartridges are designed for initial training and shooting and hunting. It's Junior brand. Sport hunting. Is it Klimovis stamping plant? How that's pronounced. It says, with steel cases, non-corrosive. Keep out of reach of children in danger than 1 mile. So. These ones are made in Russia, so they're newer than this, anyway. But I've only had the one box. I got them at one of the gun shows. This guy had a whole bunch of them, but I just bought the one. But now that I hear they're not the greatest, it's probably a good thing. But I think that's why these guns have such a vicious firing pin on them, that it's to set off those. But so here's a case. You can see what it does to the... does do it. Like, it smashes the crap out of it. But it has a really nice trigger pull. Gotta put this case in here. Empty case. Get it to feed. I don't think it'll feed. No. Alright. It has a two-stage, so it takes up and then wham. Okay, it's gone. That's a really nice ejector, actually. It really heaves them out of there. So. But you can see the... so just like your sear engagement there. This is your bolt stop. The trigger is basically just a big flat spring. And the trigger kind of bends it. And there's a big kind of like a circular thing that comes up through the receiver. And on one side it's flat. Engages with this, and the other side has kind of a claw on it that engages with this to keep the bolt from coming out. And it's all cut away here. It's flat, like in the receiver, it's round until it gets up to around here. There's a little shelf, and then where the loading slot is and stuff. So this is all correspond with that. And the ejector comes into this little groove here. It's just a block that's machined into the see it in there or not. It's a little square bit that protrudes up there. It's all milled out of steel. Like, the thing is, there's no real, you know, trigger guard stamped and stuff, but there's the receiver is like, it was milled out of a chunk of steel. Like, it's got a pretty robust little thing. So you got two extractors. They both look like they grab. You can see the firing pin in there. Just decock the bolt here for you. See it sticking out there. But it kind of comes out and kind of points upwards. That's quite a... it's kind of like the... it looks like sort of like the end of like a... those chisels for chipping stuff, or not chipping stuff, but some of those chisels, they have that sort of that weird shape to the end of them. But there's the safety part. See the spring in there and stuff, but I'm not too sure on these come apart. I looked it up and some were saying you just turn this part and this will come off, but I don't... there's some pins and stuff that go through, which I think this pin here goes through the back of the firing pin and stuff, so I don't know. I'm not really sure. It's hard to find information on it. So there's a picture online that has one of these bolts laying like this, and then there's one in pieces laying next to it, but it doesn't seem totally clear if you need to take pins out to get it apart, or if it, you actually can just twist it in a certain way and take it apart, but I didn't want to mess with it too much, but it doesn't seem to be nothing really wrong with it, so I don't really need to take it apart or anything, but it's a very nice gun overall, though. They're fairly inexpensive. I think a lot of people didn't have like a high opinion of them or something, but they are good little guns. And I like sights. Like that's what's more cool than having sights you can plink out to like 250 yards with like a 22. So that's pretty cool. Because I'm a big fan of sort of plinking with 22s, but like, you know, brought up on like Cooies and stuff, but they got little, the back sights on them are just, you know, just this little elevator, but they don't really mean anything. And then I got those Swedish 22s, and they have actually, some of them have a, like a 50, 100, or no, 20, 50, 100, 200 setting on the back sight. And I've actually shot one of them out to 200 like yards or meters or whatever. And they're fairly close. Like, and so this one here would be kind of cool, because this one actually goes 25 meter increments. So, but I don't really know if they intended on them actually shooting at game, at, or not game, but I don't know, in case the wolves are trying to eat your kids or something, or I don't know what stuff goes on in Russia, but those wolves trying to eat your cow or something, you can take pot shots at it or something, I don't know. What, maybe it's just for messing around, I don't know. But it seems kind of strange that they would put that much range on the sight, but I know a lot of them are like that too, like the TOZ-8, like the target rifle, I think it goes out to like 200 or something as well, and I think they all, like a lot of them have the same sight, like the, it's like TOZ-17, which is like basically identical to this almost, but it's the box magazine, and it's a whole bunch of different ones, but I had one of the newer ones, but they're not quite a lot different now. These are like the old school ones, but anyways, I'll probably have a shooting video soon. I won't be shooting that steel stuff, I don't think. Got some agula, or I always called it aguila, but I got some of this stuff recently, the standard velocity, which is probably what this gun's probably more geared towards, but just want to see how we do a video and shoot it, well, within 100 yards anyway, but I might, if I'm in the woods or something, I could shoot a little further, but it'd be interesting to see how it stacks up at 25, 50, 75, you know, all the different distances, and see if it's actually on, or getting ammo that it actually makes it so that it actually hits on. So that'd be kind of cool anyway. I always liked that with my Swedish guns. They always, you know, with the range, it actually was pretty close. So that actually made it really nice when you're in like a some sort of 22 shoot. People with scopes are kind of stuck with, you know, they shoot like low, really low at close, and then you're right on at a certain distance, but then at 100 it's hard to compensate sometimes, but with those guns you can just crank the sight up as you went from like, you know, 25, 50, 100 kind of deal, and it made it a lot easier. And I've actually done really well with one of those old beat up old Husqvarna 255s, which the one that I usually won everything with, or won a few shoots with, it only cost me like $79, I think, back in the day. And I think because I had a broken extractor, I think that's why it didn't cost me much, but I think I bought a junker one that I took the extractor off of. But, so I kind of hope that this one will be, because the trigger on this is actually better, like that two-stage, kind of really big fan of that. Kind of funny, it's kind of like a little miniature Mosin in some ways, but it just, other than the trigger, actually the trigger sort of operates the same, it just has a big flat spring that this bends, So it's more like a Finnish Mosin trigger sort of thing. Anyway, thanks for watching. Hope you find this interesting, and talk to you later.